FMG 58 pharmacology session. So pharmacology, we're gonna first see about the first MCQ is father of pharmacology. Who is father of pharmacology? Oswald Schimmelberg. Oswald Schimmelberg. So pharmacology is basically divided in Indian father of pharmacology is Colonel Sri Ramnath Chopra. So pharmacology is basically divided into general pharmacology and systemic pharmacology. So general pharmacology, we deal with the pharmacokinetics, pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. Pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. In the pharmacokinetics, we deal with the route of administration. Route of administration. So we have various route of administration. The important one is IV have a bioavailability of 100%. I am only emphasizing the MCQ. IV have a bioavailability of 100%. So what is mean by bioavailability? Bioavailability is indicated by the your letter F, where F is equal to area under curve of oral divided by area under curve of IV into 100%, and that is one more MCQ. IV do not have a first pass metabolism. IV does not have a first pass metabolism. So what is meant by first pass metabolism? Metabolism of a drug. Metabolism of a drug in the liver. Metabolism of a drug in the liver before entering into systemic circulation. Okay. Important MCQ, metabolism of a drug in a liver before entering into systemic circulation. And second, we have absorption. The drug is absorbed and then followed by your distribution. So distribution, we have a volume of distribution. Volume of distribution is equal to dose by concentration. And higher the plasma protein binding, lower the volume of distribution. Another important MCQ. Whatever I am talking about is a MCQ. Okay, whatever I am emphasizing here is the MCQ. Okay, next you have your distribution followed by your metabolism and excretion. So in metabolism and excretion, you have to know two things. Number one, formula for clearance. Clearance is equal to 0.695 into VD by T half. And next, clearance is volume of distribution in 0.695 into volume of distribution divided by T half. And the second important thing is it is mediated by your cytochrome P450 system. Metabolism is mediated by cytochrome P450 system. Most common one is your 3A4 and the second common one is your 2D6. Number 3 is our order of kinetics, law of kinetics. So law of kinetics, it is classified into two types, namely first order and zero order. So the first order kinetics is also known as linear kinetics, where the rate of elimination is directly proportional to concentration. While in the case of a zero order kinetics, it is a non-linear kinetics. And what are the drugs which follow? Zero order kinetics. So drugs which follow zero order kinetics, remember with the mnemonic of ANSI, like alcohol, warfarin, aspirin, theophylline, dalbutamide, and phenytoin. So remember with the mnemonic of ANSI wants Alan and Tanya to party. Okay, this is a important thing about your pharmacokinetics. Next you have your pharmacodynamics. So pharmacodynamics deals with what drug does to body. So drug binds with the receptor and produce the action. So what are the drugs available? Drugs may be either classified into agonist or antagonist. Agonist or antagonist. So the agonist drugs are the one which binds with receptor and activates the receptor. Binds with receptor and activates receptor. While antagonists are the one binds with the receptor and make the receptor unavailable for agonist. Make the receptor unavailable for agonist. Okay. Next, you have a types of antagonism. Among them, you have your important highlighters: intrinsic activity cannot be achieved as one in partial agonist. Next you have your receptor types. You have a four types of receptor: ion channel receptor, G protein coupled receptor, enzyme linked receptor, and nuclear receptor or intracellular receptor. G protein receptor is again classified into three types, namely GQ receptor, GS receptor, and GI receptor. GQ receptor will act on phospholipase C, thereby increasing the DAG or PAP2 concentration, and in turn increases your IP3 inositol triphosphate concentration, in turn causes your increased intracellular calcium level. Okay, well, GS and GI both acting on your adenylate cyclase, and in your adenylate cyclase thereby converting your more ATP into cyclic AMP. So this is all about your receptors, and you have to know a few other things. For example, like in potency, efficacy, and therapeutic index. So potency is nothing. For example, drug A requires 200 mg to produce vasodilation, while drug A requires 200 mg to produce a vasodilation, while drug B requires 100 mg to produce the same vasodilation, then drug B is more potent than drug A. So this concept is known as potency. And efficacy is a concept by which the maximum action can be achieved. And therapeutic index marks the safety of a drug. Okay. So this is all about your general pharmacology. One more important thing you have to know is clinical trial. I'm not going to explain every clinical trials, every phases. Phase 4 is for post-marketing surveillance. That is the only important MCQ they will ask you. Post-marketing surveillance is phase 4. Okay. This is all about your general pharmacology. Next, we move on to ANS pharmacology. So, in the ANS pharmacology, you have your cholinergic and adrenergic neuron. Cholinergic neuron. Neurons which transmit acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter. Okay, so since acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, it stimulates the parasympathetic nervous system because it is a major neurotransmitter of your sympathetic postganglionic as well as parasympathetic nervous system. adrenergic neuron is a major neurotransmitter in your sympathetic nervous system. In the sympathetic nervous system. Next, your parasympathetic nervous system composed of your cholinergic receptors are classified into three types, namely M1, M2, M3. Okay, so M2 receptors are present in heart. Very important MCQ. M2 receptors are present in heart. Rest all are not important, but if you want, you have to know that it is a gastric gland and CNS for M1. Rest all for M3. Okay. Next, you have a sympathetic nervous system which contains your alpha and beta receptors. Okay, which contains your alpha and beta receptor. We will discuss that later. Okay, we will discuss about a cholinergic drug. Cholinergic agonist. We have a direct acting and indirect acting. Direct acting cholinergic agonists are acetylcholine, methacholine, third one is your betanacol, fourth one is your pilocarpine and sevimelin. So betanacol is used for B for bladder, remember. So it is used for the action of urinary bladder. Since it is a urinary bladder action, so what is the treatment? So the treatment for the overreactive or the urinary retention is for the treatment of urinary retention. Betanacol is used for the treatment of urinary retention. M for M, methacholine acts on myocardium, and pilocarpine and sevimelin acts on your Sjogren's syndrome. Dry mouth and Sjogren's syndrome. Very important MCQ. Whatever I am discussing are important MCQ, people. Okay. And in the case of a indirect acting one, you have your physostigmine, neostigmine, adrafonium, and you have your tacrine donepezil. Physostigmine. You have your tacrine donepezil. Rivastigmine galantamine. Okay. So then you have your pyridostigmine. Neostigmine or pyridostigmine is a combo which we can use. Either neostigmine or pyridostigmine, because they both have a similar actions. I am going to only highlight it. Adrafonium, test for myasthenia gravis. Neostigmine or pyridostigmine, this is a diagnosis for myasthenia gravis. And neostigmine or pyridostigmine is used for the treatment of myasthenia gravis. What is the test? Tensilon test or propagative test. Okay. Next, you have your tacrine, donepezil, rivastigmine, and galantamine. All of them are anti-Alzheimer's drug. It is not only used for the other things, it is also used for your post-operative paralytic ileus. Neostigmine and pyridostigmine is a drug of choice for post-operative paralytic ileus and post-operative urinary retention. And what is the other thing we can say, like muscular relaxant in cobra bite. Treatment for muscular relaxant in cobra bite. And you have your belladonna poisoning. Drug of choice for belladonna poisoning is physostigmine. Belladonna poisoning. Okay, so you have a cholinergic antagonist now. There are a lot. One important thing is here, cholinergic antagonist. Botulinum toxin blocks the release of acetylcholine from the synapse. Acetylcholine into the synapse. Next, you have your organic phosphate. Treatment for organic phosphate is atropine or pralidoxime. So we have our MN blocker. Specific receptor blockers are important. Only the drug name, MN blocker, pyrenzepine or telenzepine, M2 blocker, tripitramine, M3 blocker, darphenazine. Okay, so this is all about your thing. And drug of choice for organic phosphate, you should never forget atropine or pralidoxime. So this is all about your cholinergic neurons. Then you have your adrenergic neuron. So I told you adrenergic neurons, you have your alpha receptors as well as your beta receptor. Alpha 1B is present in blood vessels. One important MCQ. B blood vessels. And alpha 2 receptors serves as a break for antisympathetic activation. Antisympathetic one. Okay. And beta 1 receptors are present in heart. Beta 1 receptors are present in heart and JG cells also. You should never forget. And beta 3 receptors are present in adipose tissue, coronary vessels, and urinary bladder. Okay, and beta 2 rest all. Okay, so among them beta 3 receptors are important, beta 1 receptors are important, alpha 1 receptors are important, alpha 2 receptors are important. Okay, remember with the mnemonic of alpha 1 beta 2, that is A B C D. Alpha 1 is for vasoconstriction, beta 2 is for vasodilation. You should never forget this mnemonic. Okay, so what are next important we have to know about your important and highlighted points of your adrenergic neurons. Okay, adrenergic neurons, you have your alpha agonist and alpha blockers, beta agonist and beta blockers. So you have adrenergic neurons as a catecholamines. So the catecholamines are used as, number one is adrenaline is used as a drug of choice for anaphylactic shock. And next you have your dopamine for cardiogenic shock, drug of choice for cardiogenic shock. Okay, but if the cardiogenic shock without oliguria, then you have to give norepinephrine also. Without oliguria, you can give norepinephrine also. Next, this is all about your shock and the catecholamines. Next important function is, it is the opposite or the against your parasympathetic nervous system. So one important MCQ in alpha agonist is they can be nasal decongestant like oxymetazoline. Metazolines are used as a nasal decongestants. And you have your phenylephrine is an important one. why phenylephrine is important one, because phenylephrine is a mydriatic without cycloplegic. It have a mydriatic property, but it does not have a cycloplegic property. Cycloplegic property. Another important MCQ. Next you have your aprocolonidine or brimonidine, also used for the treatment of glaucoma. Also useful for the treatment of glaucoma. Next you have your clonidine, used for the treatment of ADHD and Tourette syndrome. Next, for the treatment of hypertension, you can give a methyl dopa. Next, you have your beta agonist A, B, and C. Beta agonist can be classified into beta 1 agonist, beta 2 agonist, and beta 3 agonist. So among them, beta 3 agonist I gonna emphasize here, because beta 3 agonist, the drug name is mirabegron, useful for the treatment of overreactive bladder. Very important MCQ, overreactive bladder. Next important one is your alpha agonist and alpha antagonist and beta antagonist. Alpha antagonist important ones are prazosin, doxazosin, tamsulosin and all. Okay, all of them, among them, prazosin, doxazosin, tamsulosin and so on, all of them are used for the treatment of scorpion sting. One important MCQ, scorpion sting. Prazosin you have to choose as a most important one, and your tamsulosin and xylodosin will be used in your benign prostate hyperplasia, or expert benign prostate hyperplasia, and this tamsulosin and xylodosin will cause a special side effect known as floppy iris syndrome. Not only that, all the alpha blockers will give rise to floppy iris syndrome. Okay, these are the important thing you have to know in the case of this one. All the zosins are mainly used for overreactive bladder. Okay, overreactive bladder, treatment of scorpion sting, benign prostate hyperplasia treatment, side effect is floppy iris syndrome. All of them are pretty high yield MCQ you have to know. Okay, and in the case of a beta blockers, they will ask you like a selective, non-selective beta blockers, and what are the cardioselective beta blocker is one important MCQ. Cardioselective beta blocker is dobutamine. Okay, so next is your CNS. Your CNS first topic we're gonna see is anti-Parkinson drugs. The anti-Parkinson drug, what is meant by Parkinson disease? In a simple word, too little dopamine or too much acetylcholine. So either you have to increase the dopamine, or you have to decrease the acetylcholine. So how to increase the dopamine? So increase in dopamine by supplementing a dopaminergic neuron, but it is not, dopamine cannot able to cross the BBB, dopamine cannot able to cross the BBB. So what we can give? So the first drug is D2 agonist, because we can activate the dopamine receptor and shows like the dopamine is more. And number two is your prodrug levodopa. That is, this levodopa may cross your BBB and convert into dopamine in the CNS. So this levodopa is peripherally converted into dopamine by dopamine decarboxylase enzyme. So this dopamine decarboxylase is inhibited by carbidopa, another important MCQ. So peripheral dopaminergic conversion is inhibited by carbidopa. Now what happened? This levodopa may either convert into 5-O-methyldopa. 5-O-methyldopa. 5-O-methyldopa by the enzyme COMT. COMT. Catecholamine O-methyl transferase enzyme. So the COMT is inhibited by your two drugs known as entacapone or tolcapone. Entacapone or tolcapone. Tolcapone is now avoided due to hepatotoxicity. Important MCQ. Due to hepatotoxicity. Next, you have your levodopa may be converted into other metabolites. Levodopa may be converted into metabolites by the enzyme MAO, monoamine oxidase. This MAO is inhibited by selegiline or rasagiline. Selegiline or rasagiline. Okay, so this is all about your Parkinson's disease with the increase in dopaminergic activity. So pseudo-Parkinsonism is associated with another important MCQ. Antipsychotics like haloperidol. Okay, we should never forget. Okay, next, too much acetylcholine. You have to block the too much acetylcholine. So what type of drugs you can give? Trihexyphenidyl or benztrophin. So remember with the mnemonic, park my Benz. Benztrophin is for Parkinson. Okay, so this is all about your Parkinson drugs. Next important thing is your anti-epileptic drugs. Okay, so what is the anti-epileptic drugs you have to see? So the anti-epileptic drugs you have to see is, first one is drug of choice for status epilepticus. Drug of choice for status epilepticus. What is the drug of choice for status epilepticus? The drug of choice for status epilepticus is BZD, benzodiazepines. Okay. So next is, what is the drug of choice for absent seizure? Sodium valproate in India, or ethosuximide, and you have your phenytoin. Side effects of phenytoin are important. Phenytoin can be given in all type of seizures. Phenytoin causes your fetal hydantoin syndrome, or maybe like osteomalacia, contraindicated in pregnancy. You have your vitamin K deficiency and so on. Okay. next important thing is you have your lacosamide. It is a recently approved drug for the adjuvant therapy for partial onset of seizure. Partial onset of seizure. I'm not going to stress more on your this thing. Let's move on to the next one. Sedatives and hypnotics. Next chapter on CNS is sedatives and hypnotics. BZDs and barbiturate. So what are benzodiazepine? What is the main mechanism of benzodiazepine? The main mechanism of your benzodiazepine is acting on a GABA receptor. Acting on a GABA receptor. So this benzodiazepine will bind to the site other than the drug interaction site. So what happens with the benzodiazepine? So these benzodiazepines are the drugs which acts on your GABA receptor and increases or prolongs the benzodiazepines act on GABA receptor and increases the frequency of opening of chlorine channel. While barbiturate acts on GABA receptor and increases the duration of opening of chlorine channel. Okay, very very important one is antidote for BZD poisoning is flumazenil. Another important MCQ. This is your and you have your next important one is your melatonin agonist. Which is useful for the treatment of narcolepsy. Which is used for the treatment of insomnia. Ramelteon, which is used for the treatment of insomnia. Okay, so this is all about your important one. Next important one is your antipsychotics. Extrapyramidal effects are important. What are extrapyramidal symptoms? So the first one is acute muscular dystonia. Treated by benzoxol because Parkinson like symptoms. Number two is akathisia. Propranolol is a drug of choice. Tardative dyskinesia. Valbenazine is a drug of choice. Malignant neuroleptic syndrome. Your dantrolen is a drug of choice. Very very important MCQ. Very very important MCQ. You should not miss. Okay. I am only highlighting the highlights here. So lithium is used for the treatment of another important MCQ in CNS is lithium, especially in antipsychotic. Lithium is used for the treatment of drug of choice for bipolar disorder. And lithium greater than 4 MEQ will in turn causes your dialysis. In turn makes you to go for dialysis because greater than 4 is your toxic dose and it can damage to your entire organ. So you have to go for your dialysis. Okay. Next important one is your CVS. So in your CVS, name of the antiarrhythmics are important. anti-arrhythmic drug and their classes are important drugs. So anti-arrhythmic drugs, the important ones are last one is sodium channel opening. Never forget sodium channel opening. Class 1 A, B, C is, and class 2 beta blockers, class 3 potassium channel blockers, class 4 calcium channel blockers. Now recently we made a class 5, which is other drugs, miscellaneous drugs. So classes and the mechanism of action are quite really important. Next you have your diuretics. Most important diuretics is loop diuretics. And you have your furosemide, belongs to this category. Okay, they act on the loop of Henle. Spironolactone is a potassium sparing diuretics. I am only highlighting the MCQ people. Is the potassium sparing diuretics. Mechanism of action of cardiac glycosides is sodium potassium ATPase inhibition. ATPase inhibition. Another important MCQ. You should never miss. And drug of choice for our first line of drug for hypertension is it's always thiazide diuretics. You should never miss this topic. Okay, next important thing you have to know is your antimicrobial. You have your cell wall inhibitors. Cell wall inhibitors, you have your penicillins and cephalosporins. So all of them are like the most useful ones. And in the case of a cephalosporins, cephalosporin is divided into five generations. What are the important MCQs? So first generation cephalosporins are used for gram positive cocci. Second generation cephalosporin is used for gram negative bacilli. Third generation is used for most of the organisms. Fourth is also most of the organisms. Okay, ceftazidime is a drug of choice for melioidosis. Ceftazidime, important MCQ. okay. Next, you have your protein synthesis inhibitors. So this protein synthesis inhibitor, remember with the mnemonic, buy at a 30 and sells at 50. Okay, so buy at 30, aminoglycosides and tetracyclines. Aminoglycosides and tetracyclines sells at 50. Double C E double L S. So clarithromycin, chloramphenicol, erythromycin, lincomycin, and linezolid. And finally, streptogramins. And you have here. And then you have your nucleus disintegrated receptors. Okay, so the new one which acts on your nucleus is trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole, and you have fluoroquinolones. They act on your bacterial nucleus. Important side effects are Gray baby syndrome is caused by your chloramphenicol, and Redman syndrome is caused by vancomycin. Orange color urine is seen in rifampicin. And so on. Okay. So, antiviral drug. Next important one is, for a specific condition, drug of choice for leprosy is always dapsone. The parameters have been covered already in your PSM, so no need to explain everything. Okay, so next you have to go for your antiviral and antiprotozoal. So most of the condition, acyclovir is the important antiviral. Acyclovir you have to give all the bits. Next is your antiprotozoal ones. Albendazole or mebendazole is the most of the thing you have to use for the protozoal infection. I am hereby concluding the pharmacology. Whatever the concepts I have been explained is important concept. There are few drug of choices list I don't want to emphasize, so I attached in a script. So kindly download the script and read the script for the pharmacology drug of choice. Drug of choices are pretty important one. Okay, thank you.